I'm James Taylor, and this is the Bodybuilder Sculpting video. We're going to take a look at making this guy in Mudbox. So I'm picking up where I left off with the texturing video. I've got my guy here. I've subdivided him to level 5. I'm turning on symmetry and using my bulge brush. And I'm using a relatively large brush size and a weak brush strength to just block in my basic forms. I'll start with the rib cage. It defines a lot of the torso. And then I'm going to lay in the abdomen, and I'm just kind of sketching in these shapes. There's the obliques. They sit under the rib cage and just kind of curve around to meet the abdomen. And then I'll turn around to the back, and I'll start with the traps up at the top, and they're basically a big kind of T shape. And I'll start to exaggerate some of the other shapes in the back. Now, when I modeled this guy in Maya, the silhouette closely matched the image reference. That means that all his musculature is already built into his silhouette. That's why I'm using a relatively weak brush. I don't want to change the silhouette too much. I just want to add definition. Now, my next step is to turn off symmetry and start to build in shapes that are specific to this person's body. And this is where my texture reference comes in handy, because I can see the forms of the body specifically laid out over the geometry. So I'm still using my bulge brush, and I'll build up on top of the areas that I've already started sculpting on. Here I'm working on the rib cage, and as I add that detail, you'll see the next thing that I do is I go back in and I smooth it all out. So we want to get a nice even blend where the sculpted strokes blend back into the surrounding surface. We don't want to be able to see any discrete sculpted strokes. Here I'm working on the abdominals, just building them up. Remember that the abdominals are not symmetrical. Make sure you do these asymmetrically. Now I'm adding in some of the obliques around the abdominals. The abdominals are framed by the rib cage above and the obliques to the side. We can see how they all flow together, creating this nice kind of diagonal gesture in the side of the body area. But during the blockout phase, we're not just pushing out, we're also cutting in. So you'll see I'm turning on symmetry, and I'm using my foamy brush, and I'm cutting in around the bottom edges of the pectorals to better define the shape of the muscles there. And the foamy brush, I have it set so that it has a very sharp fall off, and it's set to be a negative value so that it carves in around the body shapes and I can better define musculature. So up to this point, our texture has helped us with anatomy, but we need something a little bit more defined. In these photographs, the bodybuilder is lit from the sides instead of from the front. We can see that this makes the anatomy really pop. Not so great for textures, but we'll see that it's very effective for sculpting reference. So for example, the definition between the pectoral and the deltoids is much sharper in these photos, and I can use my foamy brush to carve in and to create that same sharp detail on my sculpt. However, we can't rely entirely on our textures. When I turn it off, we can see that a lot of blending needs to happen to our mesh. So I'm going to go through and smooth a lot of the sharp edges of these brush strokes back into the mesh. The goal here is to have a nice smooth blend where every shape fits into the whole. And we can only do this when the texture is turned off. So I want to start carving in more of this same kind of sharp detail. I'm going to step up to my level 6 subdivision, create a new sculpt layer, and I'll leave my texture semi-opaque so I can see the sculpt detail. I'll use my foamy brush to go in and start to carve in the really fine, sharp details that I see on that texture. We definitely want to be using a graphics tablet here because we need to be able to control the pressure. We want each stroke to start off shallow, cut to deep, and then end shallow as well. Now, I'm carving around a lot of the different muscle groups that we see here, and these sharp, defined lines that I'm cutting in are going to be extremely important for creating that high-resolution detail that we're looking for. And you'll see I turned on another texture projection that highlights the serratus muscles. That's what I'm carving in right now. Basically, I want to go in and highlight as much of the detail as I can, really kind of exaggerate it right now. I'm not cutting in too deeply, but I am making sure to be very thorough to go in and cover pretty much every area of the abdomen that I'm working on so far. Here, I'll just cut in to create a little bit of the belly button, also build up around the outside edges and smooth all of that back in. And then I'm going to turn my attention to the back here. The back is challenging for an artist because it tends not to have the same level of definition as the front of the body, and we end up with a mismatch where the front of our sculpture looks extremely detailed and the back tends to look plain by comparison. Okay, after I've cut in these lines and I've got the detail, I'm going to turn my texture off again so I can see the results of my sculpting. And I'll see that it looks like I've just drawn lines on top of the surface, which is exactly what we've done, but we've got to get it to blend in a little bit better. So I've turned on my erase brush, I've set it to a low strength, and since I sculpted this detail on its own sculpt layer, I can use the erase brush to fade the detail into the main surface. And you can see that I'm painting mostly on the end points of the lines. And so the result is that the lines gradually kind of build back up into the surface. We get this nice kind of fade out effect that definitely helps things blend together better. Now, once I'm happy with the erasing, then I'll turn to the smooth tool. And with the smooth brush, we can actually create a new layer, a new sculpt layer, and smooth on that sculpt layer so that we can always step backwards in case we make any mistakes or we over smooth. So remember, we want to avoid the appearance of any individual sculpted strokes. And this is usually most evident at the end points, the beginning and the end of each stroke. And so that's where I'll usually focus my smoothing so that those end points blend in. But you'll see that I'm also smoothing along the edges of strokes. And this is to make sure that I get a nice gradual blend, that I don't get just a very linear cut that looks like I've drawn onto the surface. Rather, the entire stroke just blends into the surrounding muscle. We get something that looks very natural. This can kind of feel like we're undoing our own work, but this is really the way the actual body works. We have these muscle shapes that are under the skin, and then the skin stretches over them and it kind of blurs out the shapes. And by using our smooth brush in this way, we're just kind of replicating that. So this has all been happening at level 6. I'm going to step all the way down to subdivision level 4 and create a new sculpt layer. And I'll turn on my wax brush with a relatively low strength. And I'll use all the sharp foamy detail that I created previously as a guideline to placing these wax strokes. And so the idea here is that I'm creating striations or just generally organic shapes. And I'm using the detail that I carved in previously as a guide for the direction that those shapes are traveling in, kind of the size of those shapes as well. I feel like most people like to create a really symbolic version of a human being where all the muscle groups are perfectly defined and they're all exactly symmetrical and laid out exactly as a textbook would have them. The thing is, real human bodies don't work like that. They're never so well defined. And by creating this kind of shape using the wax brush, I'm basically adding in that kind of organic detail, that lumpiness that makes it feel more like an individual living organic creature as opposed to just some idealized, symbolized comic book character. And with this technique, I'm going to create a lot of detail on the back. So I'm going to place these strokes in such a way that they kind of follow the direction that the muscle fibers pull in. I'll also use a relatively small brush so I can get multiple strokes into a small area. And once I'm done adding that kind of striation detail, I'll start smoothing everything back into the surface. When I'm doing this smoothing, I'll use a small brush again. I don't want to blend the entire shape together. I just want to smooth everything together without losing that nice organic detail I just spent all that time creating. I'll also use my foamy brush at this point to start to emphasize the edges of the shapes that we've just created. And when I'm doing this, I'll use a bigger brush radius that'll give me less of a sharp pinpoint line. It'll give me more of a smooth curvature. I'll continue with the foamy brush after I've stepped up to level 6, my highest level of subdivision detail, and I'll use it to add asymmetrical detail to the back where I'm better defining the back shapes. I'm carving around the edges and I'm focused on the spine area here. And when I'm adding this detail in, I'm doing it pretty randomly. I'm just carving in organic looking shapes so I get some nice weird curvature. And then I'll blend that all back in using the smooth brush. And while I'm doing this, I want to look at it from very oblique angles. So you'll see that I'm looking at it from below or from above. And I'm just checking the displacement of the surface. So I'm making sure that nothing bulges out too far. And if it does, I'll just use my smooth brush to bring it back in line with the rest of the surface. Let's switch over to the neck. I'm blocking in the volume for the sternocleidomastoid muscles around the neck here, and I'm using my wax at a low subdivision level to just add the overall mass for that muscle. And then I'll use my foamy to go around the edges of that and just carve it in a little bit so I get a bit sharper refinement around the edges. After I've done that, I'll blend it in with my smooth brush as usual, and then I'll use the wax to build up the clavicle. The clavicle sits just above the pectoral, connects from the front bottom part of the neck all the way out to the shoulders. The overall shape is curved, kind of like a horseshoe. And there's a negative volume that sits right behind the clavicle, right at the base of the neck. I'll just hollow it out using either the bulge or the wax brush. Now, getting a nice smooth curvature for the clavicle is pretty important. It can be difficult to wrestle with that. So in this case, I've turned on steady stroke for my foamy brush. And then I can drag that in a smooth curve along the edge until I get the shape that I'm happy with. Pretty much the same process over on the arm. I bulged it out, and now I'm using the wax brush to start to build up striation detail. And then I go back and I smooth it all into the surface. So again, it kind of feels redundant, but I find this is the way that I get the best results. In the case of the elbow here, you'll see I use a lot of wax strokes. That's because I want that area to be slightly rougher. And I'll continue with the wax strokes to build up that region, but also the rest of the forearm. So I'll use it to create the bone shapes, and then I'll add the volume under the forearm, that big massive muscle down there. But I'm using the foamy tool extensively as well, with a relatively large brush size, to help define the curvature around these muscular shapes. So again, anytime we have these muscular shapes, they're bulging out against the skin. That generally means that we're gonna get a nice rounded profile, and so the foamy tool helps us achieve that. And the same approach works nicely on the legs. So I'll use the wax to block out the overall shape for the musculature, and then I'll immediately smooth it back into the surface. And so I'll get the nice curvature. But unlike the bulge tool that I used in the beginning, the wax tool can be used to create harder shapes like the knee and the shin area. A little bit of extra volume will help down in the calves, but a lot of the work here is going to be done with the foamy brush. So we can cut in sharp edges to define the muscles, and then after we lay the foamy in to create the base detail, we smooth that back in to blend it into the surface. And in this case, I'm doing it in multiple passes. So I'll lay in the basic shape with the foamy first, and then once I've got it defined, I'll use my bulge or my wax to build up the edges of the muscles around the foamy, and then smooth it all back together to create a nice shape. And we can do the same thing on the back here as well, where I've used the foamy tool to block in my shapes, but then I'll go in with the wax brush to fill in the volume around it. So the foamy creates the sharp edges, but I'm always using other brushes around the foamy to get a nice bulge to make it actually feel like muscle. Here I'm cutting in the high level detail for the knees. This is the same process I used to carve in the detail around the abdomen. And you'll watch as I carve these details in, you'll see that I split a lot of lines that could be a single line into multiple lines. And this gives us a much more organic feel as opposed to using a single line traced around a muscle shape. So this sharp negative brush is a great way to create detail, but if we go too far, things look fake. We can see here that the lines in the chest and the shoulder are defined way too sharply, and so we have to go in and smooth those back out. We can also use the fill brush to just paint along the edges where we need to smooth things out, and it'll basically look like skin is being stretched between the two areas, which will soften out that too sharp look as well. I also ran into the same problem on the abdomen. This is another area where we need to pay a lot of attention. The pectorals are also a good zone where we'll have that sharp detail that might look a little bit too sharp that we might have to go back in and clean up. Now, when I was polishing the sculpting in the abdomen area, I realized that the back, especially around the obliques, is a little bit too thin. And so I have to go in and fix that up by adding more mass into that area. And this is where sculpting on layers really comes in handy. I can step down to a much lower subdivision level. I can create a new layer there, and I can add volume into that region. And it's not going to disturb any of the high-res sculpting I've done on the higher levels. So I can fix the shape of the body, and at the same time, I preserve all the sculpted detail that I've created in there. Okay, here's a neat trick to use painted layers to affect our sculpting. I've got a textured layer that is just the briefs. I'm going to select that, right click it and do freeze from selected. And we'll see that it freezes that part of the mesh. And then I can invert that freeze by going to edit and invert freeze, and it'll freeze everything but the briefs area. Now I can sculpt this out using a very large bulge brush set to a very low intensity. And the result is we'll get just part of the mesh popped out. The borders will be relatively sharply defined because they were defined by a texture. And then all we'll need to do is go in and clean it up a little bit with our smooth brush. And then we'll do a pass with the pinch brush. And the pinch brush will just draw both the texture and the sculpt detail together. And the result will be a very nice, sharp border between the briefs and the body of the character. Afterwards, I went in with my wax brush and I laid in the stitching detail for the cloth that's on the briefs. And then using new sculpt layers, I used my bulge brush to go in and add the wrinkle detail based on the wrinkles that I'm seeing in the texture that's applied to the surface. I'm also improvising a few wrinkles. Anywhere where there's going to be stress on the fabric is just a good area in general to add wrinkle detail. And that wraps it up for this video. Still to do, we have to sculpt the head, one of the most difficult sculpting challenges a character artist faces. And we've got to start adding skin detail and other tiny high-resolution details that are going to make our sculpt look really good. I'm James Taylor. Thanks for watching.